Hey, how are you? Thanks to Hollywood, when we think of pirates today, we either think of Johnny Depp doing his best Keith Richards impression, or an emaciated Somalian telling Tom Hanks, "Look at me, I am the captain now." While those images make for entertaining movies and memes, today we'll be talking about some pirates from history that are downright terrifying. Not to discredit Captain Phillips and his crew, as I'm sure being held hostage wasn't a pleasant experience. First up, we got the French pirate François Léonès, who was so famous for terrorizing and plundering Spanish settlements in the Caribbean, he was given the nickname the Bane of Spain. He once captured a couple Spanish soldiers while trying to find the settlement of San Pedro in Belize. And when they refused to tell him how to get there, he cut out one of their hearts and started to gnaw on it like a dog toy. To no one's surprise, the other soldier immediately showed him a clear route to San Pedro. Karma always wins in the end, though, and François was captured and eaten by cannibals on his way there. Next, let's talk Captain Morgan, who before becoming a popular rum brand amongst high school kids with older siblings willing to buy them booze, was a notorious British pirate who was also hell-bent on stealing as much gold from the Spanish in the New World as possible. When he sacked the city of Portobello in Panama, and the locals wouldn't tell him where their treasure was hidden, he employed a popular pirate torture method known as wolding, which is when you wrap a cord around a victim's head and slowly tighten it with a metal bar until their eyes pop out of their skull. Funnily enough, drinking a bottle of Captain Morgan today will also make it feel like your eyes are popping out of your skull the next morning. That's a little cheesy hangover humor. I apologize. Another form of torture believed to have been used by pirates and the Dutch Navy back in the day was keel hauling, when a rope is tied beneath the belly of the ship and the offending pirate is tied to said rope and dragged underwater along the helm from side to side. The bottom of most ships was covered in barnacles, so the pirate was shredded to pieces and drowned simultaneously. Fuck me. Just put me in one of those saw contraptions and save me some misery next time. Then there was Ned Lowe, who set off from Boston to become a pirate in 1719 after his wife died in childbirth. He once captured a bunch of Portuguese sloops, but to his surprise, didn't find any money on board. However, after putting the crew through a casual torture sesh, one of them admitted that their captain had thrown a large sack of gold overboard as Lowe and his men were boarding. Not a fan of gold going to waste on the ocean floor, Ned promptly cut off the captain's lips, cooked them, and forced the captain to eat them. Yep, you heard me right. He fed the captain his own lips. But if it makes you feel any better, his own crew would later maroon him on a deserted island for being such a dick. Now let's take it all the way out to China to talk about our first female pirate, Ching Shi, aka the Pirate Queen. Before becoming a pirate, she worked as a prostitute in a floating brothel, which were known in China as flower boats. However, after marrying Zheng Yi, who was in command of the infamous Red Flag Fleet, the largest pirate fleet in the Far East, she stopped slanging punani and joined her husband in the family business. When Zheng Yi died only 6 years later, Ching Shi took control of the Red Fleet, which at that point had grown to include 50 to 70,000 pirates. Under her command, the fleet continued to flourish, gaining control of most coastal villages in the region, and strict rules were put in place regarding the treatment of prisoners, in particular female captives, stating that the ugly ones were to be released unharmed, and any pirate who took a beautiful captive as his wife and then was unfaithful or failed to take care of her would be executed. Ching Shi became known as the Terror of South China, probably because anyone who resisted her orders would have their feet nailed to the ship and beaten repeatedly. Unlike some of the pirates I've mentioned, though, her story didn't end tragically, as she eventually made peace with the Chinese government and was allowed to return to her hometown and run a casino until she died. Now, don't get me wrong, there were many pirates that abided by a strict code of honor and refused to use torture against their enemies or their own crew. And many pirates were officially sanctioned by their own government to only plunder from ships their nation was at war with, a practice called privateering. But those stories wouldn't make for as entertaining a cartoon now, would they? Anyways, hope this gave parents some ideas for making their kids' pirate Halloween costume extra spooky this year.